Good morning all. This is M.R. Shekhar, working as an assistant professor in St. Martin's Engineering College in the Department of Civil Engineering. And I belong to the Structural Engineering Specialization. And today I am going to deliver a content regarding strength of materials subject, which is a very important subject in the civil engineering aspect. Strength of materials. So, for a civil engineer, being a civil engineer, to become a civil engineer, so having the knowledge of strength of materials is a major thing. Without having the knowledge of strength of materials, okay. So, for everybody, it's going to be very tough. And a person without having an knowledge of strength of materials subject, okay, doesn't call him as a civil engineer. So strength of materials is going to play a key role in a civil engineering career, right? So where we are going to study about all the basic concepts which are related to many civil engineering subjects like structural analysis and design of reinforced concrete structures and design of steel structures. And advanced concrete technology, advanced structural analysis and rehabilitation and retrofitting of structures, concrete technology, right? So all these things and all these subjects are very much interrelated, and what are all the basic information required to know, to study about all those subjects, right? So strength of materials is a mandatory thing, okay? So first of all, we will start from the name of the subject itself, strength, right? So strength, in what way we can able to define the strength? Basically strength is nothing but it is the ability of a material to withstand the external force. Ability of a material to withstand the external force. And we know that all the materials in the universe are every material in the universe is having its own strength. Not all the materials are belongs to only one strength, right? So not only the strength, okay? So each and every material is different in its own properties, whether it is strength or density or weight or anything, right? So in all the different parameters, the materials are different, right? So strength is nothing but the ability of a material to withstand the external force, right? So that is the way we need to define the strength. And basically, here in the subject strength of materials, we are going to test the strength of different materials under different circumstances. Okay, under the application of different types of loads and stresses. Right? So here, strength is nothing but ability of a material to withstand external force. Here force is nothing but if anything externally acting upon a object or any material or on a material, right? So that external thing, okay, that we can call it as a load, okay? So load is nothing but the force. So external force acting on a body, that is nothing but the load. So the material, the ability of a material to withstand the external force, that is nothing but the strength, right? So in this strength of materials, okay, we are going to study about different things like stresses, strains, and the stress strain diagrams for different materials like mild steel and other materials, right? So as of now, in this lecture, okay, I am going to give the fundamentals of strength of materials. Fundamentals of strength of materials, and let me discuss about the different types of beams and different types of loads. Different types of beams, loads, and different types of supports. So different types of beams, loads and supports. Okay, these three are the basic things which are needed, okay, to learn any structural related subject in the civil engineering, right? So without knowing the type of beam and without knowing the type of load and without knowing the type of support, okay, if an engineer doesn't can't able to construct a single room. So having the knowledge of all these things is mandatory, okay, to become a civil engineer, right? So let me discuss, let me define all these things first. After that I will discuss about these things and categorize according to the types, right? So first I will start with the beam, right? So beam basically beam is nothing but it is a structural member, and we know that a structure consists of a number of members like beam, slab, column, wall, foundation and so on. Many things, many structural elements are there, right? So in all those things, beam means nothing but it is a structural member which is subjected to transverse loading. Transverse loading is nothing but load in the horizontal direction. Load in the horizontal direction, right? So that we can call it as a transverse load. So beam is a structural member and that is subjected to transverse load, right? So beam, it is the basic objective of beam is to convey the entire load, okay, to the remaining structural elements, okay, equally, to distribute the load uniformly, right? So, and coming to the loads, load, as I told previously when I'm explaining the definition of strength, right? So it is the external force, okay, that is acting on a particular body or material, that is nothing but the load, right? And coming to the supports, and we know that support, okay, without providing the supports, it's not possible for us to construct a building or any house, any type of structure, right? So that is nothing but the support, okay? Without the foundation and without the supports, okay, we cannot even construct a single room, okay? So that is what the supports. And let me, before going to know about the beams, okay? So it is necessary to know about the supports. So now let me start the supports first, okay? So there are three different types of supports we have, okay? One is fixed support, second one is pinned or hinged support, pinned or hinged support, third one is pronator support. So these are the three supports we have basically. So that is, first one is fixed support, second one is pinned and hinged support, third one is roller support, right? So this fixed support is nothing but which is fixed, which will be fixed, right? So let us consider a beam, right? So fixed means it is to be fixed at both the ends, right? So this is what a fixed support. In this form also, we can draw a fixed support, right? So the beam which is fixed in between two supports, right? So this particular beam, we can call it as a fixed. Okay, about this beams, we will discuss here in case of beams. Now, as of now, as we are the part of supports, right? So let me explain these supports also. Pinned or hinged support, right? So pinned or hinged supports, right? So this is the way to represent the pinned or hinged support, right? So coming to the roller support, right? Coming to the roller support, where we need to provide the rollers at the bottom of the support, right? So this is the way to draw a roller support. Here, one one important thing to be remembered and to be studied in case of supports, right? So for we know that in case of strength of materials, okay, equilibrium equations to be there. Equilibrium equations. Equilibrium equations means if consider a structure, right? So consider a structure or a beam, right? So if on this particular beam, right? So here one horizontal load is acting, and here also one horizontal load is acting, and on the beam three vertical loads are acting, right? So if because of here and here, because of the horizontal as well vertical force is acting, okay, what is going to happen? A moment is also going to generate. A moment is also going to generate on the beam, right? So a moment is going to generate on the beam, right? So here what I want to convey is for a any type of support, right? So any type of support in our structural engineering or strength of material, right? So equilibrium equations are very much important, right? So here some of the horizontal forces, right? So some of the horizontal forces, nothing but sigma h equal to 0, right? So sigma h is nothing but some of the horizontal forces are equal to 0, and some of the vertical forces sigma v is also equal to 0, right? So next sigma m, right? So m is nothing but the moments. Here the moments are generated where horizontal as well as vertical forces are acting on the structure, right? So sigma h equal to 0, sigma v equal to 0, and sigma m equal to 0. So these three equations, sigma h equal to 0, sigma v equal to 0, and sigma m equal to 0, are termed as equilibrium equations. So number of equilibrium equations always it is going to be 3, right? So here in case of support, right? So here one more thing we need to know, that is nothing but the reactions, right? So how many reactions are there for each support, right? So if it is a fixed support, right? So the number of reactions will be, there will be a horizontal reaction, and there will be a vertical reaction, and there will be a moment also, right? So we know that wherever there is two forces acting in different directions, horizontal as well as vertical, a moment is going to rise. So for a fixed support, the number of reactions will be 3, right? So for a pinned or hinged support, so here while it is pinned to that particular beam or hinged to that particular beam, okay, where moment does not able to take place, right? So only a horizontal reaction and a vertical reaction are going to take place. That's why the number of reactions here in case of fixed beam 3, and here in case of pinned or hinged support, that is 2. And coming to a roller support, okay, it's not possible to apply force in vertical direction, okay? It will not move, right? So only in case of horizontal reaction there will be movement, and reaction is also in the horizontal direction. That's why the number of reactions for the roller support, that is going to be 1, right? So this is what the story of supports: fixed support, pinned support, and roller support, right? So for fixed support, the number of reactions will be 3, and for pinned support, the number of reactions 2, and for roller support, the number of reactions, that is 1. And coming to the loads, okay? So we have basically 3 different types of loads. Let me erase this information about the supports. Right? Coming to the loads. Okay, loads. Basically, we have 3 different types of loads. One is point load. Second one is UDL, uniformly distributed load, and third one is UVL, uniformly varying load. So basically 3 different types of loads, okay, are going to act on any structure. Like different types of loads are there seismic loads like live loads, dead loads, and wind loads. Okay, basically coming to the structural loading, right? So point load, UDS and UDL. What are the direct loadings are there? That direct loading will be categorized as these three different types. Right, so point load is nothing but a load which is acting on a particular point. A load which is acting on a particular point. So let us consider this load acting at a particular point. Okay, for load basically is the external force, and this will be any the units for this is newtons, kilonewtons, or anything. Right, so let us consider it a kilonewton load is acting at the midpoint, exact midpoint of the beam. Right, so this particular load we can call it as a point load or concentrated load. So right, so if this is the load which is acting at a particular point, and there will be an area of concentration. Right, so even theoretically, okay, we can define it, the load which is acting at a particular point, but that acting load influence will be there on the beam up to certain extent, right? So this is what that certain extent. This is what that certain extent, right? So this area, this length, okay, whatever the length of the beam which gets influenced by this point load, okay, that is that we can call it as the area of concentration, right? So that's why this load, this type of load, okay, we can call it as point load or concentrated load, right? So this is what about the loads, and this is what about the point load. Coming to the UDL, right? So UDL is nothing but it is a type of load. It is a type of load which is equally distributed over the entire length of the beam. Over the entire length of the beam, for this point load, the units will be Newton and kilonewton. Right, so which is acting at a particular point, but here in case of UDL, right, so where the load is uniformly distributing over the entire length, right, so consider this length of the beam as L, right, so and so this load will be W, right, so here the load which is going to distribute over the entire length of the beam, the units are also going to be Newton per mm or Newton per mm square, right? So here it is only acting at a particular point, that's why it is Newton, and here it is distributing over the entire length, that's why Newton per mm or Newton per mm square or Newton per meter, anything, right? So based on the length given in the problem as mm in the form of meters or anything, right? So that is what UDL. Next, UVL, this is uniformly varying load. This is uniformly varying load, right? So it will be the uniformly varying load, it will be a triangular load or parabolic load or anything, right? So where it is varying from point to point, right? So let us consider different points. First, second, and then third. Right? So at the third point, this will be the load. And second point, this will be the load. And the first point, it will be the load. And at the zero, the load will be highest. Right? So according to the length, when the load is varying, according to the length, when the load is varying, and at the first meter, the load is, let us say, consider 10 newtons. And here it is 5 and here it is 2 meters. So according to the length, if the load is varying, then we can call that particular load is uniformly varying load, right? So here also these are the three different types of loads. One is point load or concentrated load, second one is uniformly distributed load, and third one is uniformly varying load. These are the three different types of loads. Now next, coming to the beams, as we know that beam is a structural member which is subjected to transverse load. which is subjected to transverse load. So basically we have three different different types of beams, like simply supported beam, and second one is cantilever beam. And third one is continuous beam. Fixed beam. Next one is overhanging beam. And the next one is propped cantilever beam. Right, so propped cantilever beam. So these are the six different types of beams we have. Firstly, simply supported beam is nothing but it is a beam which is freely rested at its two ends. Right, so let us consider as a beam. Right, so this one which will be rested freely at its two ends. Right, so here you can expect any type of support. Right, so simply supported beam is nothing but which is freely rested at its two ends. Okay, for example, you can tell a room with a single beam. Right, so here this cantilever beam nothing but a beam which is fixed at the one end while the other end is free. Which is fixed at one end while the other end is free. Right? So, for example, practically in our daily life also, in our home also, like the doors and windows, we can call them as examples for cantilever beam. Okay, if we apply the force at the free end, right? So, if we apply, if we want to open the door or close the door, right? So, at the free end, we need to apply the force, and at the fixed end, the rotation is going to take place. Right, so that is one example for cantilever beam. And continuous beam, if the supports are more than three, okay, if the number of supports are three or more, right, so then the particular beam we can call it as a continuous beam. Okay, nowadays in all our apartments and any large scale commercial or residential structures, right, so all our school buildings and college buildings, okay, all you can tell them as a examples for continuous beam. And fixed beam. Fixed beam is nothing but which is fixed at both the ends. Right? So fixed at both the ends. Next, overhanging beam is nothing but a beam which is extended beyond its source. A beam which is extended beyond its supports. Okay, if a beam length is extended beyond its supports, then we can call that particular beam as a overhanging. Okay, bridges. Okay, if a walkway is there and we need to construct a bridge on that, okay, definitely we need to lay the supports first and after that. Okay, from two or three supports, the roadway will extend. Okay, and it will merge into the actual way. Right, so that is what the example, practical example for overhanging and proper cantilever beam. And we know that cantilever beam is nothing but one type, one end is fixed and other end is free. Right, so if a load is acting at a certain length on the fixed support, right, so then we can call it as a proper cantilever beam, which is carrying the load not from the end and from a certain distance. Okay, to the starting point, right? So this is what about the beams, loads, and supports, right? So thank you all. Thank you for giving me this opportunity.